One of the best articles that I've read about positioning is this one that is on the First Round Review. And this is actually the one where I work through my own positioning statement, and they have some examples. So I want to walk through a couple of examples of different companies' positioning statements to help you better understand what we're talking about. I know I already did mine, but it's good to look at sort of real companies that you might know. So for Amazon's positioning statement, they say, for worldwide web users who enjoy books, Amazon is a retail bookseller that provides instant access to over 1.1 million books. Unlike traditional book retailers, Amazon provides a combination of extraordinary convenience, low prices, and comprehensive selection. So there you have it. Their audience is huge. Worldwide web users. For people who enjoy books, that's a giant audience too. They talk about how they position themselves as a retail bookseller. This is when they were starting out. This is their early positioning statement. And they have lots more than 1.1 million books now. But that's like, wow, that's a ton of books compared to traditional book retailers. And then they talk about the convenience, the low prices, and the comprehensive selection being the things that separate them. Let's look at Harley Davidson, the motorcycle manufacturer. So they say they changed it up a little bit, but the only motorcycle manufacturer that makes big, loud motorcycles for macho guys and macho wannabes, mostly in the United States, who want to join a gang of cowboys in an era of decreasing personal freedom. A lot going on there. So their audience, at least when starting, was mostly the United States, and still probably is mostly the United States. They're targeting specific guys, people who are macho guys, but also people who want to be macho, because we know there's a difference there. They talk about what they make, big, loud motorcycles. And it's for people who want to join a gang of cowboys in an era of decreasing personal freedom. So this is kind of going to help them determine how their voice, the types of advertising they do, the way their advertising looks. The rest is kind of directing where they're putting that advertising, who they are targeting with it, but this is really going to determine their voice and how they separate themselves from other companies, including the big loud motorcycles, because that is really what sets them apart. All right, so I hope these two examples help you come up with your own positioning statement, and I can't wait to see it myself. So please complete the assignment, send it to us, and we'll give you any feedback, advice, critique that we have. Thanks, and see you in the next lesson.